Yes, let's go to the second team. Rohit, Shruti, Shravanti, and Sandhya. They are presenting on usage of antimony as nanoparticle ion batteries for e-vehicles.
Yes, sir. Okay. Yes, I'll be presenting my screen. So, yeah, experience of review paper writing. Thanks for the invitation and thanks for conducting this for the second time and listening to this the same words. But let me try to put this in different way when compared to last time. So, experience of review paper writing by Team ISCE. First of all, before going to review paper, let me talk about this Team ISCE and what ISCE deals with. So, to tell this, it takes guts, it takes gumption to tell this. I would take that for now and I'll explain you. So before ISCE, so what is the main basic principle that drives you to focus on this project is waste to wealth. So you've been seeing many, many people and many areas where people are focusing on converting waste to wealth. There are a number of processes going on converting waste to wealth. So in one region, the entire school is made of plastic waste, furniture, school walls, and etc. So in one place, a paper which we are writing, shining white paper, it is made up of elephant pee. So in one place, a person is using technology to convert banana leaf into a useful product. So there are many processes going on in and around us to convert waste to wealth. So how it is means, so there are quite processes going on. So what makes ISCE special in converting waste to wealth? How it add more value when compared to other innovations or inventions that are going on? So ISCE, so it's industrial symbiosis for circular economy. It's an innovative idea started by our beloved alumnus Ulhas Parlikarji to add value and to create circular economy. So when I say sir, so he's a pioneer in geocycle waste. So what can we do to avoid plastic waste? So what can we do with a waste that cannot be recycled? Like it may be hazardous, it may be hazardous dry waste. So these are all different factors we are not at all focusing previously. Of course, there is some focus earlier on that, but. So this industrial symbiosis for circular economy focus on dry waste. So previously, the as per sir explained, so entire waste, whatever we are speaking about, that are used in manufacturing of cement. So if you look at it, waste is converting into wealth in making cement, manufacturing of cement. So as part of it, we are looking at sustainability. So I strongly believe ISCE comes under sustainability, which we are aiming for. Sustainability means having resources with us and hoping for the future generation to use that resources, right? So Agenda 2030 formed by UNO with 17 sustainable development goals. We are also comes under the industry infrastructure SDG, so one of the sustainable development goals, and in the process we are creating global circular economy. So in our regular conversation, we talk about waste, we talk about wealth, we talk about adding value, and we talk about creating global circular economy. So here you can see picture how circular economy works. So it's all a journey, a sustainable thought journey and adding value journey. It's interesting, and Ulhas sir keeps on asking, are you interested, are you excited? Of course we are excited, sir. So every time you have a call with us, we are very excited and we are fortunate to be in this project, circular economy, and together we can make a difference in the sustainable environment and make the world sustainable. Yes. So after ISCE, so when we started journey with Ulhas sir in regard of ISCE, so we started thinking on writing a review paper. So what made us to write a review paper? What is the motivation of writing a review paper for us? So first thing, it's through discussions. So this discussion, when we and Shravan sir were discussing in 2019, so the major trend we observe, so mostly MTech, master's students or PhD students write review papers and research paper. There may be students writing in bachelor's too, but the rare case is belongs to bachelor's. So we were discussing why not a bachelor student can also write a review paper and get the research exposure. Right. So though the time that was thinking, so we were thinking that impossible to write a review paper for Belgium. So it's possible. So we are making this impossible to possible. So impossible to possible. So the idea was planted in 2019, and the action is taking place here in 2021. Meanwhile, a research review paper has also got published by one of our teams, plasma activated water. Hearty congratulations to them, and that also act as a motivation for us to write a review paper. And one more motivation for me personally, it's Top Talk given by our Dr. Sharma, VP Supati Garu. So engineering challenges in carbon constrained world. I was inspired by the way sir explained about the critical minerals. So how critical minerals plays a major role, how we should mine, how we should focus on that. So that is one of the talks I realized that there should be a focus on critical minerals. So the work and research going on the critical minerals is very critical. So we thought of focusing on that, and that driven us to focus on this antimony as a nanoparticle, which comes under rare earth metals or critical mineral, one of the critical minerals. So, and one more, our inquisitiveness to learn more. Along with ISCE, Industrial Symbiosis, so review paper writing, so we are very interested to write, and we are excited. So in the journey, learning one and keeping interest on other will take some time. So we balanced both, and we were excited totally, and we are excited now to explain you these all things. So these are steps to be taken while we were we observed whatever we observed, and we are taken from Sharma sir and Ulha sir, just letting you know about how to start a review paper, what are the steps to be taken while writing a review paper. So it's all our learnings from our mentors. So identify the research gaps and choose a particular topic from those. So choosing a particular topic takes more time. It's very crucial part in writing a review paper. So the you have enough resources, you have number of resources and number of research and review papers available to you, but you know, at that point of time you are in a dilemma to choose whatever the topic. So maybe you are interested in nanotechnology, but the information is vast, what to choose and what to focus on particularly. So focusing on a particular topic is very important, such that we can make points out of it. So skim and scan it thoroughly and understand. So after you selected a topic, so what is specified a topic, so these are all comments we learn from our mentors. So skim and scan it through so it thoroughly and understand. So whatever you have taken a topic, you should skim and you should read thoroughly and understand the concepts or points regarding the topic, and consider only required content and try to eliminate other points. So if you, even if you are into the specific one, you'll be having number of points to that topic. So just consider whatever you require. So as Sharma sir said, so you should look at the audience, whom you are focusing on. So based on that, you should make some points and consider only that content. So critical evaluation is needed. So as sir said, so whenever I message Ulha sir and Sharma sir, they respond in such a way we always love. So these are all points. So critical evaluation is needed. So it should not be like X did this and Y did this. So it should infuse like X did this, Y X got these results, and Y did this and Y got these results. So you should infuse the scientific knowledge into it and critically evaluate while writing a review paper and summarize all your findings and take reference from different modes of review paper writing, like as we have different styles of writing. And with these thoughts, let's start writing a review paper or white paper. So you'll be having a fun in writing a review paper and learning experience, a better learning experience. So we are topic usage of antimony nanoparticles in potassium and batteries. So Sandhya, Shravanti will be continuing. So why we have chosen it? Shravanti, what
do you think? Actually, many people point out that why do we use antimony as a nanoparticle? Why can't we use it as a bulk? So the reason is that during potassiation, it's a process where potassium ions are added into the metal. It leads to the breakage of the conductive network. It increases mechanical stress in the network, which leads to decrease in performance of the potassium ion battery. So that is the reason we have chose antimony as a nanoparticle, so that we can increase the performance of the battery. The next doubt you may get is that why do we choose potassium ion batteries? Because there are other alternatives such as sodium and lithium. Owing to the low cost and recyclable technology, we have choose to take these batteries. And concerns about the scarcity of lithium have driven many researchers to look for alternatives such as potassium ion batteries. And also potassium resembles with the properties as those of lithium and sodium because they belong to the same group. It can lead, using potassium may also lead to a environment friendly technology because there are no toxic chemicals used in the process of potassium ion batteries. So where do we use potassium ion batteries? We use them in electric vehicles. Yeah, Shruti Akka, can you continue?
Yeah, like Sandhya said, mostly EVs that are functioning right now in today's time in the market, they run on lithium ion batteries. But potassium ion batteries are being looked into as a viable replacement because, as we know, potassium is an available in abundance in the Earth's crust. So the cost also will be lower. Whereas lithium, the availability is low, whereas the demand is high. So the cost just shoots up. So researchers are looking into potassium ion batteries. And since they fall into the same group 1A, they have similar properties. E-vehicles are nothing but vehicles but that run on electricity. So since they run on electricity and not on fuels like diesel or petrol, there's no fuel being burnt. There's no combustion happening. So there are no emissions. At the same time, there are also low maintenance. And there are a lot of advantages of using EVs. The major one is it's environmentally friendly compared to conventional fuel-run vehicles. So that's the reason why we chose to put our focus on e-vehicles. Because one thing that we kept in our mind before starting was we want to focus on sustainable development. The UN has given sustainable development goals that we need to achieve. One of them is achieving sustainable cities and communities. So using EVs can to some extent help reduce emissions and reduce air pollution. So that's why we focused on e-vehicles. And in potassium ion batteries, we use antimony nanoparticles in the anode materials. So that's that. And for the future prospects, as far as we looked into it and we've read a few articles and papers, there's not much focus on the safety aspects of potassium ion batteries. That hasn't been looked into. That's why it's not actually used in practical applications. So that is one thing that future researchers will have to focus on if we want to see potassium ion batteries being used in future upcoming e-vehicles.
So our experience, so it's a decentralized leadership. Yes sir, it's a decentralized leadership. So we were not I should only the person to give a reply. So it's a decentralized, I liked it more, most importantly. So our learning, we have learned about ISCE, industrial symbiosis, how it works actually. So it's a kind of adding value to both industries. So one of the waste material from one industry is being used as a raw material for the other industry, right? So it's a synergy, it's a symbiosis between both industries, and that's what we call it, industrial symbiosis, and it is creating a global circular economy. So these are learnings about industrial symbiosis, and a weekly conversation with Ulha sir and taking suggestions from our mentor. So it helped more, and we learned more about review paper, how it should be started, and our special thanks to how to write a review paper aspect. So we took help from our teammate Vivikta's father help. So he also helped Vishnu Garu. So he also helped us to tell about how to write a review paper. He has given a nice presentation. So what are the points to be focused on writing a review paper, different styles about writing a review paper. So if these both are perfect, like our experiencing this this process and digging out the interest in it. So we are, as I said, we are excited. So we learned many things. So these two can automatically generate results. So this will generate result in a huge way. So we hope for the best, and we have given our effort, and we are eager to learn more and more. And thanks. I think our team experiences should also be listened to. You, so Shruti and Sandhya, you can go ahead.
So definitely I got to know the format of a review paper written in a very professional way. So I just want to share a few experiences, not to waste much of time. At the beginning, I was told that the topic is critical minerals. I thought, will that be beneficial for me? I was a bit confused whether to join or not. But the topic, when I got to know that it is about e-vehicles, antimony, nanoparticles and all, the topic itself is very interesting because e-vehicles are playing a crucial role in the current scenario. I was very amused with the topic. So I started working with the team. We used to have regular meets where we used to interact. We also used to have meets with Ulhas sir, just to know the progress of our paper. Sir used to guide us, used to give us some tips where areas where we could improve even more. So also my team, they were very encouraging and supportive. Yeah, that's it. Thank you.
Thank you, Shruti. Shruti? Yeah, so before I joined this team, I didn't even know there was something called review paper existing. I only knew research papers existed. So after joining this, that was the first learning point for me that something called review paper actually exists. So, and once I joined the team, I joined a bit late. So I was a bit worried, will I be able to catch up with them or not? But my teammates were like very supportive. They were very patient. They were ready to like help me out whenever I wanted. And this whole thing has been like a learning experience by itself because I wasn't even aware about which batteries are used in EVs before. Like now I know a lot more and I learned a lot more about sustainability and renewable energies and all those things. And besides that, just interacting with people because we've been stuck at home in the pandemic. So it was nice just talking to people in this scenario. That's it.
Thank you. So it's creating a circular circular happiness also. So let's experience this circular happiness. That's nice. Thank you.
You know what, Rohit? Actually, we need guts to listen to you.
Yes.
Thank you. One quick question for you guys too. Like, what's the interesting challenge that you faced or you found?
Challenge is interesting anyway. So from when we started writing a review paper on a topic called critical minerals, so as I said, yes, so critical minerals, so it's a huge, we have a huge information on that. Picking out a particular or specific topic out of the whole is a challenging task. So at sticking to the antimony, so we started from critical minerals and then cobalt, nickel, and then rare earth metals, and then critical minerals in India and in critical minerals in abroad. So what are so it depends, right? So critical minerals we call in India, so beryllium is a critical in India as we searched. So making out points out of them. So and after critical minerals, after rare earth metals, antimony. So why antimony? Antimony is whether to use antimony bulk material or nanoparticle. So antimony in potassium ion batteries. So what about lithium and sodium? So what are the research going on lithium and sodium? So why not focus on potassium ion batteries? So and again, why not use antimony nanoparticles in potassium ion batteries? And that can be used as a material for e-vehicles. So it's against sustainability. So our ultimate aim from the start is focusing on sustainable development. As how IAC is also focused on sustainable development, so we also focused in writing a review paper on sustainability. So it's a challenging one, I keep on telling you. So taking a specific topic is very crucial. So this is also we learned from our mentors. So Ulhas sir was keep telling that. So take a topic, so that should give an overview, just so you should tell the reader information, not you should not tell the entire part. He doesn't have time to look at it. So these are learnings, so we have learned a lot. So this is a challenging interest, so it's interesting at the same time. So we were excited and we are excited now also, so we'll be exciting so in the future as well. So working with a team is an amazing one again. So yeah, results are automatically generated when we look when we take these points into the interview.
That's so interesting. Thank you, Rohit. Sharmaji?
Now you can hear me. Actually, you guys have done a fantastic job. of you know, basically communication wise, you know, this is very good and goal is very nicely articulated. One question, you mentioned very important topic, actually, like you want to look at further into safety aspects, which is absolutely important. Why do you want to suggest safety aspects? Is there a problem? You need to highlight that. First of all, if we say, I want to do this, the one thing you have to think about is why. In a paper also, why is there a problem that you anticipate? And that is the reason you are warning people to look into that? Or is it just like that, okay, be a nice boy. Or, be nice to your neighbors. That's a very good suggestion. But is it a general statement or is it specifically, are you seeing a problem there with potassium? That's something that you may want to highlight. I'm sure you are addressing these things, but I'm just looking at what was, as a person sitting in the audience, when I listen, what is missing there? All right. Now you said decentralization. Are you writing this for policymakers or are you writing for researchers who want to look at the safety aspects or who want to look at the technical aspects, how we can put nanoparticles into this? We cannot mix and match. So if you are writing central decentralization, what is the problem with central? Did you identify any problems?
Yeah, like so leadership.
I'm not, you don't have to answer. I'm just saying you need to think about and say, okay, these are the problems that the industry is facing or the country is facing or this. So I recommend this. Then you have a basis for your recommendation. Not like, just casually, let's all be happy. Yeah, that's a very good statement. Why we should be happy? You know what I mean? So those are the only two things. But let me tell you, you guys have done a marvelous job in articulating. I really like your presentation of what a review paper should consist of. And you're sticking to those principles. And you have done why potassium is, I really like it, actually. You explained it, you articulated it very well. And you need to give statistics. Always when you are saying, okay, this is not used much in your mind, maybe different in much in my mind. You have to say what much is. I see this in my own graduate students or sometimes as you increase temperature, this is increasing. Okay. Increase from 5 to 10 or increase from 5 to 5 million. There is tremendous difference. A vague statement like that we should not write in a solid, substantiated article. I'm just giving general suggestions, nothing specific to your paper. Don't get that, So when you say something, in writing or orally, we should be able to defend that with numbers, with data. So keep that in mind when you are completing it. You just say, okay, I'm saying decentralization because centralized operation will not work for these reasons. So the best thing would be decentralizing. All right. Why, how, when are the questions that every sentence you should think about when you are writing these kinds of papers. But I tell you, you guys have done an excellent job. And I'm so impressed. You're thinking totally out of the box. And you are coming back and presenting great ideas that I don't have to think all the best ideas, but it was eye-opener to me. Let me put it that way. So it is a great job that you guys have done. So, but together we can improve that. That's the reason I'm giving you these messages. All right. I'll leave it up to the other experts to talk about. And there are 25 experts here that I see all faces here right now. Okay, so I will leave it there. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the suggestion.
Thank you, sir. Prakash, sir.
Yeah, as Dr. Sarma sir told, yes, you have done a great job. All interesting topic again. So I'm clearly watching the energy transition market. So I will make only a couple of points, which I'm very sure will be addressed in future review papers. One is, as Dr. Sarma sir told, so yes, we know that lithium ion batteries have hit some, there is a challenge with respect to availability of lithium and the efficiency of the lithium battery. Okay, so what is the constraint that lithium ion batteries are contributing to the EV market commercialization, and how potassium ion batteries are going to replace? It comes to statistics. What are the constraints and how potassium is going to support in the EV vehicles, and what is the time to market? So this will give much more, you know, it will make your paper much more rich to the audience. That is first. And again, I also see from a purely from market perspective that hydrogen electrolyzers are coming, which are being developed, which is again addressing the challenge that lithium ion battery is unable to support the EV. So a comparison. So now we have a lithium ion battery supporting EV, potassium ion battery, a challenger, which is going to come up, and hydrogen fuel cells based on the renewable energy. So some comparison, which will finally contribute to the EV market, the evolution of the EV market and the timelines, so that, you know, it will become it, at this young age, when you present, when you include slowly in future, that will really make the audience very happy to see these figures. That's all I have to say.
Thank you, sir. Ulhasji, do you want to add something?
No, I think both Sharma sir and Prakashji have added the most important aspect, you know, of the entire submission that you have done. A good presentation and good learning, you know, that is more important according to me. You know, I mean, review paper will get published or not is another story, but the amount of information that has gone into your mind today, you know, is something which is very valuable. And that is something which, you know, I value personally much more than anything else. In terms of the relevance of EV, you know, nothing should be stressed more. It is very important today globally. And of course, different ways and combinations are being looked at worldwide to make it more economical, more sustainable, etc. So you have chosen a topic which is adding value to the whole thing, and I'm sure that, you know, I mean, it may not be a reality today, you know, in terms of whether the potassium based ion based you know, these batteries are really commercially exploitable or not, but I believe that a paper like this, you know, if it gets into the scientific world, will really create a lot of you know, brainstorming and research interest in taking it forward. I like the you know, concern that you raised about the safety aspect, because the safety information is not available on that. And for anything and everything that we want to do commercially, the safety is a important criteria. I mean, if nothing is known or if nothing is considered as important, is a danger. And I think you have tried to address that issue also, to look at whether, you know, there is any safety information available or not. As an engineer, you have done that good job, according to me. You know, every engineer in every activity that he is doing, he has to start looking at the safety aspect, because he is going to play a very important role in sort of giving comfort to the stakeholders, you know, which are going to be around the project that you are designing. So that's a very important aspect, safety. And, you know, it has, at least in my role, as an industry person, the first thing that I had to value was safety only. Because every time, very, very mundane things have caused a huge accident and fatalities, you know. I mean, just that, you know, people have not ignored something. considering it as irrelevant, you know, has caused major fires. So that is where I think, you know, it is important that you are also trying to look at that. Rohit and Shruti, Shravanti, everybody, you know, you have done a good job. And what most important now for us from you people is to look at the paper now, right? What has been actually documented, right? So that we may be able to add a little bit more value to it if there is something that we can. And then, you know, it can be sent or submitted for the publishing purposes. So let's explore that possibility now. Let's put some more thought, some more effort, you know, because you're doing good job. I think we should convert that into a published paper, you know, all the papers that we are talking about today. Thank you.
Yes, sir. So yes, sir. just to add a point. So from the start, whenever we have a call with Ulha sir, so he was telling, focus on methodology to write a review paper. It's not you choose topic, especially about sustainability or not. So focus on methodology to write review paper. Learn the things. So it's all, we loved it. So we are learning, sir. Thank you. Thank you for all the support from you, all the mentors support from you.
Thank you, Rohit, for acknowledging all the time, all the support from all our mentors. Yes.